Hello everyone and welcome to my talk on black box wallets, fast anonymous two-way payments for constrained devices. My name is Markus Reiber and this is joint work with Max Hoffmann, Michael Klose and Annie Rupp.
So first off, what is this all about? Many of you probably know customer loyalty programs, where whenever you do a purchase you get some points, and later on you can use those points to get discounts or other rewards. Companies offering those programs usually collect data about all your purchases made. The purchase history is then used by the company to build a profile on each customer and, for example, target advertisement based on that. This, as was seen when Target started predicting customer pregnancies, can be a problem for privacy and have other unintended side effects. Also, this data may be shared with other companies, for example, to decide whether you should be eligible to get a loan or not. Another application of our system is the envisioned vehicle-to-grid scenario, where car batteries are used as buffer to smooth over spikes in consumption and production of the energy network of the future. Here, users are rewarded for providing their battery to the network and billed for the energy consumed while charging that battery. And of course, here also the problem exists that it is possible to build profiles on where and when people park their car and thus defer, for example, when they leave for holidays or where they work and when they start and finish working. Digital toll collection is another example of where positional data can be used to build profiles on users, whereas all the information really needed to perform the desired function is the amount of toll that a user has to pay. Another example are prepayment systems, where you charge money onto your account, then for example use your phone to pay for services like public transportation in a more convenient way. Again, linking transactions may allow the creation of profiles about your personal life. All these scenarios have a common theme, where users can collect and spend some kind of coins, be it loyalty points, some form of credits for providing your battery to the energy grid, or even real money. Also, all these scenarios have the same problem, where the company can build extensive user profiles which violate user privacy. The solution for this problem has been presented at CCS 2017 in the form of BBA Plus, a building block for privacy-preserving point collection. BBA Plus provides unlinkable transactions, which prevents the creation of user profiles. It allows terminals to be offline most of the time. All it needs is that operator terminals occasionally transmit data to some central database. And it comes with strong formal security guarantees. Sadly, BBA Plus still has some drawbacks. In the following, I will first explain how BBA Plus works and then detail what the drawbacks are and how we improved upon them. First, I shortly explain zero knowledge. A zero knowledge argument of knowledge is a possibly interactive protocol between a prover and a verifier, where the prover wants to convince the verifier that some statement is true. The verifier, after receiving some messages from the prover and responding with challenges, will then decide to either accept or reject this proof, and we require three properties to hold. First, completeness, which states that if the statement is indeed true and the prover knows a witness for the statement, then the verifier will accept at the end of this interaction. Knowledge soundness requires that if the verifier accepts such an interaction, then there exists an algorithm called the extractor that will, with overwhelming probability, extract the witness used by the prover. And zero knowledge requires that the verifier does not learn anything beyond the fact that the statement is true from this interaction, which is formalized by a simulator that can simulate this interaction without actually knowing a witness. Next, I will give you a short overview over the BBA Plus protocol before I discuss its drawbacks and how we improved upon it. There are three types of parties in the BBA Plus protocol. There are users that want to collect or redeem points. There are operators that run the system. And if there are more than one operator, they need to trust each other because they will share a key. And there's a trusted third party, which will create a common reference string for the scheme and which is able to link all transactions through a trapdoor that exists in the scheme. The trusted third party is only needed to set up the system and after that is not involved in any protocols. DBA Plus has three protocols between users and operators, one for creating new wallets, one for collecting points, and one for spending points. To create a new wallet, the user first constructs a half-finished wallet and sends it to the operator together with a zero-knowledge proof that shows that it has been constructed correctly. Then the operator will finish this wallet and sign it and send the finished wallet together with the signature back to the user, which then has his wallet, which we will call token tau in the following. Then to collect points, the user first takes the wallet from the last step and re-randomizes it so that it can't be recognized anymore, and then sends this randomized wallet together with a new zero knowledge proof that shows that it's actually a valid randomization of a previously validly signed wallet to the operator. And then the operator adds the proper amount of points to this wallet and signs the resulting wallet again and sends it back to the user, which now has an updated token. And to spend points, the operator needs to know the current balance of the wallet the user wants to use. And the user will first randomize the wallet again, send it together with a zero knowledge proof that it is formed validly to the operator. The operator checks that the wallet actually contains the claimed balance. And if that is the case, it subtracts the amount of points the user wants to spend and sends the updated wallet together with a new signature back to the user. Now, BBA Plus has several drawbacks. First of all, it makes heavy use of pairings, which cause a somewhat poor performance, especially on low power devices. It reveals the balance whenever the user is spending points. If this happens regularly and points are not collected too frequently in between, then this might allow linking user transactions. And as mentioned before, there exists a trapdoor that will completely abolish privacy in the system and allows whoever owns this trapdoor to link any transactions. So we improve upon BBA Plus in the following ways. Firstly, we design the scheme to work without any pairings at all. We use wrench proofs to hide the balance during spend operations, so even in use cases where spending is done regularly, the user privacy is preserved. We also remove the trapdoor from the system, and then we extend the scheme with additional attributes that a wallet can have, which allow, for example, age verification. Besides this work, there are also two other recent papers that improve upon BBA Plus. Updatable anonymous credentials presented at last year's CCS, and a paper to appear on this year's Asia CCS. Both of them also improve the efficiency of BBA Plus in regards to the use of pairings, where they also use the same zero knowledge proofs that we do, but still rely on pairings for the signature schemes. They also make use of range proofs to hide the balance during spending, and they also get rid of the trapdoor, although they do this by weakening the security guarantees, whereas BBA Plus guarantees that users cannot trade points among each other. Those two papers do not guarantee this anymore, just that some of users cannot spend more points in total than all the users have gained up to this point. So how did we achieve our goals? First, removing the pairings. BBA Plus relies heavily on the use of pairings. It uses a zero-knowledge proof system based on pairings, which we wanted to replace with Sigma protocols. It uses commitments based on pairings, which are mainly due to the zero-knowledge system they use and can be easily replaced with Patterson commitments. And it uses signatures based on pairings. BBA Plus uses what we call the commit-sign-randomize-proof principle, where the user commits to his message, then obtains a signature on this message, and to then use this signed token the next time. It randomizes the commitment and proves in zero knowledge that it randomized correctly and has a signature on the original commitment. This approach is well suited for pairing-based primitives, where there's signatures and commitments that play very well together with the zero knowledge proof system to achieve this. But we wanted to use signatures without pairings. To avoid the need of zero knowledge proofs about knowledge of a signature, which without the use of pairings will involve evaluation of a hash function inside the zero knowledge proof, we instead use what we call the commit and blind sign principle, where the user commits to his message and then obtains a blind signature on that commitment. This hides both the signature and the commitment on which the signature was issued from the operator. And thus, the next time the user wants to use its token, it can simply send the commitment together with the signature to the operator in the plane. But we need our blind signature scheme to allow for efficient zero-knowledge proofs about the content of this commitment to prove that the commitment was well-formed. To this end, we needed something akin to the Kamene-Schlesianskaya signatures with efficient protocols. The only signature scheme to satisfy all our requirements due to Badimtsia and Lysianskaya was only known to be sequentially secure. Since we need concurrent security for our purposes, we also provide a proof in the generic group model, which might be of independent interest. Completely removing pairings provides us with a twofold speed increase, where we on one hand avoid slow pairing operations, and on the other are able to use faster elliptic curves, for example the curve 25519. The authors of BBA Plus stated that they intentionally did not use range proofs because they are too large and slow in their setting, while we can make use of optimized range proofs in our new setting. And we use bullet proofs, a popular and fast zero-knowledge range proof system, which can be easily combined with our other zero-knowledge proofs. The trapdoor in BBA Plus is only required for the security proof, and it is only supposed to be known to the trusted third party, and not intended to ever be used in the real world. But since the trapdoor exists, it could be abused in the real world, which we want to prevent. We make use of a different proof technique based on rewinding to avoid the need for this trapdoor. And since our common reference string is in fact only a common random string consisting of random group elements, it can be sampled uniformly at random, and we can replace the trusted third party with a hash function. Furthermore, even knowledge of the discrete logarithms of the group elements in a common reference string cannot be used to violate user privacy. Finally, we equipped our wallets with attributes. These attributes can be used to add expiration dates to tokens, or to add discount eligibility, for example senior pricing and public transportation, or for age verification, for example to prove that the owner of the wallet is above the legal age required to buy alcohol. These attributes are only revealed when required by the transaction, so for example the age verification attribute would not be revealed when buying only a pizza. Since the main goal of our paper was to improve the performance of BBA Plus on constrained devices, let me end this talk with a performance comparison. The following times are all taken from a smartphone and do not include communication. While our improvement to the issue protocol is probably not relevant in practice since it is only used once per user and was already fast enough, we greatly improved the performance of adding points, where our protocol is almost 5 times as fast as BBA Plus. For the sub-protocol to spend points, we implemented range proofs in two variants, one where the proof size is linear in the range and one where it is logarithmic, and then decided to prefer the larger proof size due to the much faster performance, which is a lot faster than BBA Plus with range proofs for 16-bit values, and still more than twice as fast as BBA Plus without range proofs, where spending points takes about the same time as adding points. And even when increasing the range to 32-bit or even 64-bit, our protocol still outperforms BBA Plus with only 16-bit ranges by a lot. We also compare our protocol to the more recent improvements to BBA Plus, the updatable anonymous credentials and the upcoming Asia CCS paper. Our issue protocol is faster than both of their variants, but again, this is probably not relevant in practice. Adding points is almost twice as fast as the CCS paper and comparable to the Asia CCS paper that was optimized for this operation. spending points with 32-bit range proofs, which is what the other two papers used, is more than twice as fast compared to the CZS paper, and more than six times as fast as the Asia CZS paper, where they didn't optimize for this because they expected this to only happen rarely compared to adding points. We also compare the amount of data that needs to be transmitted. For creating a new token, this is roughly the same as in BBA Plus, while adding points saves more than half the bandwidth. Regarding the spending of points, we greatly reduce the amount of data transmitted from over 14 kilobyte to less than 4 kilobyte, even when using the larger range proofs. And even when using range proofs over 32-bit, we still only need about 5 kilobyte of communication. And even for 64-bit, communication is still reasonable, although here the difference in size compared to the smaller range proofs starts to show. But even here, communicating this extra data is still faster than the additional computation. Finally, we provide some performance estimations for running our protocol on smart cards. To do this, we counted the number of multiplications in the elliptic curve required by the client for each protocol. This is the most expensive operation and will largely dominate the running time of the final solution. We then provide runtime estimations based on the performance reported on the MultOS 4.3.1 card and a coprocessor design by Unterlüggerau and Wenger for pairing-based cryptography on smart cards. Note that neither of these smart cards is optimized for running, for example, the curve 25549. And having an optimized coprocessor for this would result in much faster runtimes. Creating a new token takes 40 multiplications, which translates to 2.5 seconds on the MultOS card and less than 1 second on the coprocessor design. This is completely reasonable since this is an operation only done once. Collecting points takes 30 multiplications, which is possible in less than 2 seconds on the MultOS card and less than 1 second on the coprocessor design. Even adding some overhead for the other operations, this is well within the time that you also need to pay with a credit card. And spending points with 16-bit balance range proofs require 68 multiplications, which translates to a bit over 4 seconds on the MultOS design and 1.5 seconds on the design with a coprocessor. And here you can also see that using the smaller proof size does not pay off at all. This shows that in some scenarios it should be possible to implement our protocol on a smart card. And when using stronger microprocessors, such as ones in cars or smartwatches, our protocol will run with good performance. So to conclude, we improved the performance and made the protocol suitable for much weaker devices than it was the case for BBA Plus. We also improved the privacy in the system, both by hiding the balance during spend operations and removing the privacy trapdoor. We also reduced the trust needed in the setup of the system, which can now be replaced by a normal hash function. And we added further functionality to the protocol, which is useful in real-world applications. Thank you.